Thank you very much, Jesse, for that introduction, and thank you so much for inviting me here today to talk about preventing childhood obesity in Nebraska, innovative nutrition solutions. I'm going to talk about the two main projects that I've been working on and that have been funded by USDA. So why should we care about preventing childhood obesity and improving children's nutrition? Well, there are many reasons. First, Nebraska ranks fifth in early childhood obesity among 2 to 4 year old children. Also, early childhood obesity has been associated with chronic health conditions such as diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and also social stigmatization and depression in children. On the other hand, when we focus on early childhood for improving children's eating habits, from 0 to 5 years, that is the time when children are developing their likes and dislikes. During that age, we can set children on a lifetime of good health because they transition those behaviors, healthy behaviors, in adolescence and adulthood. So in order to address this grand challenge that we are facing for childhood obesity, we are focusing on childcare settings. Childcare settings offer an ideal opportunity to reach children in Nebraska. So how many of you know at least one child who is in childcare right now? Please raise your hand. Exactly. So majority of the children in Nebraska are attending childcare. They consume up to 5 meals and snacks every day in such settings. Also, research has shown that childcare providers' own attitudes, practices, and behaviors influence children's food intake. You know, so childcare providers can be a major force in shaping children's eating habits and dietary intake. However, childcare providers are paid an average of $21,000 per annum. There is a lot of high attrition rate, and we really need to focus on the quality childcare and workforce development. So we are addressing this, the early childhood workforce development through extension. Through Nebraska Extension, we are developing web-based interactive research-based programs that are hosted online that you can reach rural childcare providers in Nebraska too. And the other innovative solution that I would like to present is that how do we evaluate the impact of these programs, because how do we know that children are actually improving in terms of their dietary intake? So these are the two programs I'm going to present with. I'll start with the first on workforce development. So this is the MyPlate. In order to get reimbursed through the child program, childcare programs have to serve foods from all these different food groups to children. However, this is the issue. Childcare providers say that children don't like the taste of healthy foods. If we offer carrots or any vegetables, we are afraid that they will get wasted. So, you know, that's a waste of food there. So the challenge is, how do we encourage children to select and eat healthy foods? So these are some of the practices that are universally used by childcare providers. Pressure. Come on, be brave, give it a try. You can do it. Mommy will be very happy. Or restriction. Don't eat those cookies. They are not good for you. They are high in sugar. Giving rewards. This is really common. You can have that cupcake if you finish off the salad. If you clean your plate, you can have that candy after dinner. Or serving children self-selected portions. Okay, this is your food on your plate. Now you need to eat all of this. However, all of these practices that I just showed you are controlling feeding practices, and research has shown that they're actually counterproductive because they lead to unhealthy eating behaviors. Children will dislike that vegetable even more, and they will crave for that sweet food that is being given as a reward. And they lead to childhood obesity. So therefore, we need to have an alternative. So if we cannot use controlling feeding practices, what do we do? So this is the Eat Family Style program that we are developing on extension. As I mentioned, it's online, it's research-based, it includes short videos and like mealtime scenarios, goal setting, and we are also going to work with extension educators to have that additional component of technical assistance and coaching so that we don't lose that one-on-one component. There are 7 modules in this lesson. And we are using the socio-ecological model. Now it is very important to understand that if we want to focus on improving the child's behaviors, we also need to focus on the multiple level of influences, such as parents, childcare providers, and peers, their attitudes, the context. There are different kind of childcare programs, center-based versus home-based. So we need to, you know, focus on that. Urban, rural, and policies. So our program is taking into consideration all of these multiple level of influences as we strive towards improving children's healthy eating behaviors. Now the next challenge is, okay, all this is great. We are developing the program. We have our extension educators and collaborations. We are going to train childcare providers. But how do we know the impact? That is key. And in the gold standard for measuring the dietary intake of children in childcare is very resource intensive. It is manual and it is very, very challenging to practice. So with the help of Dr. Pitla in biological systems engineering and Dr. Guru, you know, we are collaborating and guiding students in Rake School, and we are developing a plate that will automate the dietary intake method. So this plate will have sensors, it will have cameras, and when the child is consuming a food from a particular food group, we will know exactly what is the nutritional value that the child has consumed per meal. So when a parent sends a child to the childcare program, they will be able to track on their app that what did my child eat? You know, when they were at school, and make recommendations based on that. And we will also be able to evaluate the impact of our programs through this new Sensi plate. Partnerships are key here. We are collaborating with all of these partners using the socio-ecological approach, and these partners are all existing. So we are working with the Department of Health and Human Services, Nebraska Department of Education, to consider policy as well as funding. And we have the Gretchen Swanson Center of Nutrition, SBSRC, ORED, and you know, New Tech Ventures as well. So this is what is really important. Early childhood is a formative foundational period for improving children's eating habits to prevent obesity. Childcare providers are ideal, but you know, the opportunity of reaching children through childcare settings is missed because they are themselves having a lot of grand challenges. There are also challenges related to food access, you know, STEM education in these settings, and economics, because they are really feeling challenged to make ends meet for providing healthy foods and evidence-based curriculum to the children. So there is a need for quality childcare and early workforce development. However, in order to address these challenges, we have to focus on multidisciplinary research collaborations and partnerships with policymakers and community. And it is also important to leverage Nebraska Extension. Nebraska Extension has a footprint in every county in Nebraska. So when we are working here on the campus, you know, developing programs, doing innovations, Nebraska Extension can really help us to reach our target audience and be able to evaluate the impact of what we are doing and make a difference. Thank you very much.